This review will be about AMT's 1965 Chevelle modified stocker. You can see that you can't build a stock Chevelle from it. You'll be building an actual race car. It's even got the floater hub included. You can see that tire is completely off the ground and it's a lot smaller than the other ones. That's what they mean by it. Something I wanted to show you on the box art, if these kits are successful, maybe they can get away to put out the 64 Ford, the 69 Falcon, and the same kind. You know I like doing these small town short track race cars. So let's take a look at everything in the box when you get yours. We'll start off with the body. Nice Chevelle body. Extra large pins on the trunk. You could either sand those down or use them as is. You know I like them. I'm going to use them as is. We got nice body detail on there. Open fenders on the front. Giant cutouts for the tires already done for you. So it's definitely built to only be that race car. Nice designs on there. Very basic. Let's get some more plastic out. We got a nice chassis. We got some springs there. We got part of the roll cage sitting loose in the box. That's nice looking on there. You can see where the padding is and where it isn't. It's actually quilted and crimped. You can hear it. So that's nice detail on there. We got our chassis frame with our floorboard, engine mount, transmission tunnel all built in there for you. We've got some nice leaf springs on the back. We've got more parts of the roll cage and bracing. What else we got in the box? We'll get this out there. We'll get this up here. We got pre-built headers, which I like. Suspension system for the back end. We've got some bars here. I'm not sure if they're part of the frame or the front bumper. We're gonna find out. We've got another roll bar here. I think that's part of the front bumper from what I can tell by the box art. We've got our engine and transmission halves, cylinder heads, belt pulley system. We've got more springs off the back there you can see. We've got our hood, a large, what looks like a, some sort of plate welded or bolted down. We're going to find out what that is. I always like looking at these before I look at the directions so we can discover everything new together. We got the nice hood pins in there, which will be easy to chrome up and decorate. We got the scoop there. We've got our wheels, nice looking race car wheels. Floater hubs on them. We've got each side of the spool in the back end there. And we've got our wheel backs for those big tires you're going to see in a minute. Last plastic parts tree. There's not a gajillion parts in this kit, but we'll be able to build a fine looking race car. We got our seat with belts molded in. That's our hood scoop for that open hood. We've got our radiator support. We've got our firewall with nice detail on it. We got more of the driver's cage with that protective panel behind him. We've got our steering wheel, nice basic design, water pumps. Looks like we got a part of the roll cage here, another part of the roll cage with padding molded onto it. For the super detail painters, you'll be all set. Let's go to the other side of the table. First on this one, we'll pull up the decal sheet. No matter how you do this car, you're going to have a lot of really nice decals left over for numbering your race car, putting names on race cars. We got Wins and Union and M&H Slicks, Valvoline, AC spark plugs, Fram filters, Hurst, Motorcraft, all kinds of sweet stuff on that decal sheet. We got a nice chrome tree, full front bumper design with the windshield or with the grill molded in, fans, intake and chrome carburation. On that big 454, it's got a fuel tank right there. Rear bumper. Here's the drive shaft back to the housing for the spool. Chrome valve covers. Big screened air cleaner. Gigantic alternator. You can paint over those, decorate it how you want. New part in this kit, like it shows right on the box, the screened windshield. That comes as a clear piece of acetate with screen printed screen on it. Screen printed screen. So that'll look nice in there. That should fit right in just like so and be the protective screen for the driver. We've got 1, 3, 5 huge pad printed Goodyear slicks in the box, 4 giant slick race tires, and 1 floater tire if you choose to use it. Now you need to know, of course, being a floater tire, it's not as big as the slicks. We can line up the one side on the bottom. You can see that it is shorter, so your car is going to sit three-wheel motion like it is on the racetrack where it lifts that inner tire in. So that's completely normal And the last thing in the box, aside from the instruction manual, are two nice metal axles. So I'm going to get to building, see how long that takes, and I'll be right back. After about 90 minutes or so, and really the parts count isn't that high, but it does require some fiddling around to get things to line up correctly. Now, we're going to go through what it shows on there. We're going to look at the manual, and I'm going to tell you what I've done a little different than what the manual says, and then we can, you know, decide when you build yours if you want to do it that way. We've got the roll cage assembled here in front of you. We've got the steering column part of the roll cage just loosely placed in there so I could make sure that it was spaced out correctly, but I have to paint those gauges up by hand, so I left that out separately so I can work on this in one paint color and then pick out the padding all the way around it before I slide it into the car. Now, they have you assemble the chassis. You have to put the front axle holes in. Those little triangle pieces we looked at, those go in right like so, so that your metal axle will slide through the engine and hold in place. The rear springs are assembled like such. You can see how they line up better, and then when you put the body on, you can make sure that they line up in the correct spot. Your rear springs are on the back like so, and the manual will sometimes leave a little bit up to your imagination. This is an exploded view of it, where they kind of tell you, you know, put the springs here, and but they don't really tell you exactly which way to line them up, same as the rear axle, which side goes up and down. That one you can see which side it should go up. But the rear springs, it just says place where the grooves are, but the grooves in the back will allow you to slide the springs up and down quite a different length there. So what you want to do is line things up first before you put your glue in. How I did mine, when I looked at the manual, it said, you know, put the roll cage to the chassis, put the firewall to the front of the roll cage, and that seems like it would make sense, and then put these crossbars to the front of the chassis. But when you start assembling your roll cage with these braces on the back, those actually go all the way to the back, and that's the only way they're going to mount up. This wall on the back of the roll cage will not mount in the front of the vehicle because we've got the transmission and tunnel here. So that actually has to go all the way to the back, right there. If you glue your firewall all the way up here, it won't make any sense whatsoever. It won't be near the back of the engine compartment. It'll be right up here. So that doesn't make any sense to me as far as it is on that manual. So this is how I've done it, and it lines up with the body perfectly. I glued the firewall right in front of the body and right in front of the floor pan, and you can see that lines up with the tunnel now. That all lines up nicely, goes underneath, fits that groove. We don't have an issue. Then I put the roll cage together and glued it very, very loosely so that it will sit back here, right at the front of the, where the tunnel's cut off. And then those braces go all the way to the back like they're supposed to. We'll have to paint the front springs of the frame separately and then slide those through the holes in the firewall. Line those up with the frame later when we do our final assembly. We'll have to use some super glue on that. So that's how I'm doing mine. Same with the rear springs. What I did was, after I glued the spool together, I laid it in the spring, and then I adjusted my rear springs on the back until I glued them in so that they were at least touching that axle, so that they looked realistic. So you could see where I've lined them up then, and I made sure that everything at least touches, and we can finish that off with super glue, and then it looks good. So that's just my suggestion. If you've built this car before and know a different way, that's fine. Go ahead, do it that way. I sanded off the chrome on that spool so I could use model glue to make a real tight join with those axles, and those are all set to go. That can be painted separately. These turn out, we were looking at parts, these turn out to be exhaust dumps with their big rings there. So those are on another tree, so I can paint them up. The belt and pulley system is all set. I'm not going to use a chrome-colored fan, so I'll be painting that all black, which will look good with the black fins of the fan in front of the alternator when I do attach that later. As we talked about, these are the front frame members and springs. These will need to be painted separately and super glued in place. When we're all done, we'll be able to detail the springs. The hood looks great. All I had to do was glue on the hood scoop. There is nothing to line it up with, so just hold it with your finger like this, turn it around, line it up on the bottom, and then put some drops of model glue in there. Then go around and run your bead around the outside, and you should be fine with that. This turns out to be a tarp that goes over the back, and it is a difficult fit. It's got some gaps there. No matter how you line it up, it's not a perfect fit, but you can see it will go in, and we'll just have to put some glue right in the front here of the tarp and some super glue in the back, and that will hold that tarp in place to protect things from flying up from underneath the car and into the cab. Glued the drums on the back of the wheels. You still have a lot of time to decide whether you want to use that floater wheel or the four. So go ahead, glue all your hubs in with your drums into the back, because if you're towards the end of the build and you decide, oh, I still want to use that floater tire, I've changed my mind, you just won't be using one of the entire inner wheel and hub assemblies then. You'll use this little part here, and you'll just be attaching it to the back of a wheel to use that thinner wheel. So you've got plenty of time to decide. That's why I glued everything together, and I'll paint everything up, and I can decide just before the end of the build whether I want to put that floater tire on. The engine looks good. The 454 looks nice. I did the starter on there. It's got the large hole so that metal axle can go through it. We saw that in the Wildcat review too. We got the heads on, so I'll be able to paint that up in whatever color choice I prefer. Doesn't have to be Chevy orange. It can be whatever you want. It's a custom build. Got the seats here, steering wheel, and the radiator hose. Those will all be painted basic black and detailed. Trimmed off the headers. Those can be painted on their own. We'll talk about the body now. The body really doesn't need any specific super fancy work, so it's very easy to work on. They give you a decision where you want to bolt those body guards on the body. You can bolt them anywhere you want. You don't have to use them at all. I glue them right along the seam of the body. I like the way they look lower with the Nerf bar. It won't interfere with the decals. If you put it up higher, you'll have to make sure you cut your decals to fit over it and stuff like that. Down here makes a lot of sense, being hit by bumpers and rails like a standard Nerf bar on a race car, so that's where I wanted to attach mine. The grill pushes in super easy, and the reason I detach the grill and push it in is so that I can attach the radiator support. I wanted to put that in there right away to stiffen up the body. I wanted to use model glue, so we just take our grill, we push it in, and it holds beautifully. Then we go from underneath and attach our radiator support, glue that in, let it dry. Then we know it's in the exact right location, and our body is ready for color coats. So I'm going to go over, start getting things painted. I've got some chrome parts left, like the rear bumper, the air cleaner, the valve covers, the carburetor. I'm going to dull coat those with a clear, and we'll see all that coming up. Thank you. Getting closer and closer to the final lap, so let's go over what I've done on the 65 Chevelle modified stocker. And I love cars like this. I love race cars you can build with your own imagination. I've got the exhaust tips here. I blacked out the tips on those with a black Sharpie. We got our tarp done. What I did was, what you saw was, I used the silver around it at first, then I did a brown wash around the edges, and then I used a silver pen to go back around and highlight the buttons and the edging on that metal framework that they would use to hold that tarp tight and taut over the back of the roll cage. On the roll cage, I went and painted in with a craft paint all the padding that was shown in the molds there. So that is ready, and I left the steel as it is. So that is all set to go on the chassis there. The chassis is ready to go with a lot of stuff. I got the seat in, which looks awesome with its belts highlighted. We got that nice T-shifter, which I just left in chrome because that's how Hurst shifters look. I even put the battery in on the passenger side up towards the front. Maybe not perfectly accurate, but it's in the kit. I wanted to use it, and there's nowhere to put it out here. I suppose you could set it out here somewhere, but I figured it'd be better protected inside. That hammered texture silver paint looks great on a chassis like this. Like they built it up, customized it. I black washed inside the leaf springs and inside the coil springs on the back so that we are all set to go, and it looks a lot nicer in a contrast. I also black washed inside the suspension arms because they are so basic, I wanted to give them a little bit of detail. You can see that spool looks awesome in that dark steel. That is going to line up nicely. I've already dry fit it, but that drops into the cradle like so of the springs. And then the engine comes down in the transmission and meets with it perfectly. And we have all that raw metal of a brand new race car showing off. Now, a race car is not going to go anywhere without its big, huge 454 power plant. You can see how leaving the valve covers a flat-coated chrome and then flat-coating the intake but black-washing it gives them a nice contrast. And then just black-washing the sides of the carburetor real dark gives that another contrast. Got our distributor on the back, got our belt and pulley system with our alternator. We've got our manifolds and exhaust pipes on and that dark steel getting ready to come down and meet up with the exhaust dumps once the car is together. And of course, we still have that hole in there for the axle, but it doesn't matter. It still looks great. It's a nice looking engine. Will look good under the hood. That air cleaner looks awesome with the black wash in there. It looks like it's pretty new, but still you can see the reflections in there. The wheel and tire package is all set up, ready to go. I pressed in one axle. The wheel, the tires, and the wheel backs all just pressed tight. They're all friction fit. Didn't have to glue anything, so why mess with glue if I don't need to? It's harder to screw things up. Front suspension consists of just those black springs. Those will go in once I have the roll cage glued in place. Those will slide in each side and sit on top of the axle towers like so, and then I'll be able to glue those to the front of the roll cage right there where you're looking. That'll sit like so, roughly, of course. And then this will go through and glue in. We'll line everything up, get it glued in, so we got those nice contrasts of the red and the black against the silver metal. The dashboard is all done, partially glued to the table because I had to super glue the steering wheel in. It's a very loose fit. You can see the gauges now. I colored them in with black and then rubbed them with a silver pencil like you've seen me do dozens of times in dozens of reviews. And we have a nice looking gauge package and steering column. And then that will get glued in just before I put it in there and the angle adjusted with super glue. We got our radiator hose ready to go. We got the hood pins on the hood. I even put that deflector in that would keep the engine from sucking in mud and anything that gets sprayed up from the track. That's in there as a part. I left that pretty chrome. Figured he'd just bolt that right to the hood. Super glued that on. You can still see it leaves the scoop open, but I like the look of that. A little bit of armor for the racetrack. Speaking of armor for the racetrack, I pushed in the front bumper just so you could see how it looks in the body. I'll do that last again. We'll do that again before I'm done. But I did glue the nice red push bar on the front to protect the front end. With that black wash in there, that all looks great. I just attached that with some super glue. That screened in windshield, definite improvement over having nothing there at all, or a big piece of glass. I love that. Like it's wire reinforced glass that he put on the front. I colored the Nerf bars silver, left them raw metal on the side of the car. I do like the look of that myself. I glued the rear bumper on, and we can see that silver back into the car, the mesh that was installed. That looks pretty awesome. I think if I did it again, I would black wash inside there as well to give it a little more detail, but we're approaching the final and I'm cool with the way it is. You can see how nicely that Mod Podge holds that in, and we don't have to worry about any kind of fogging or cracking or anything. So I am ready to start gluing things together. I'm gonna get the roll cage in, the engine in, and everything, and before I put the body on, we'll come back for a last look so you can see how that part of the car looks together. Okay, check it out. Now we've got the chassis, the wheels, the tires, the engine, the interior on, and we are all ready for the final stretch of the body just to be pressed over the top and attach the decals we want to use. So let's go over some things and we'll take a look at everything. First off, let's talk about the elephant in the room. And it's not really an elephant, but it's something I want to talk about. If you wanted to build an apocalyptic race car, this is your kit to kit bash from. Look at this thing without a body on it. It is tough. I mean, this thing is bad. I love the tarp over the back in that look. You could find another seat from another kit or different seats. You could put two seats back here. You could put some guns on the side. This thing is a really great starter for anything that you'd want a cool chassis like that for. And I didn't even see it in it until I put these giant slicks on through their axle with the roll cage in it and got it ready to go. It is tough. Check out that underneath looks great. We have to attach our manifolds, which I will do after the body is on. What I did was I cut the pipes at an angle so that I can join these on and aim them out the side of the car like that. Those will be attached with super glue right at the end. As soon as I get the body on, I'll flip it over. Then I have to decide what decals I want to use. We got a lot of nice cool decals to go on the body. Number plates, we got some names there. We got some sponsor decals. Also, if you watch the Buick Wildcat review I did just a little bit before this one, this is the decal sheet that comes with it. And in it are these really nice Ed's Paint Shop ones. And all these local racers were always sponsored by some cool mechanic shop or a store. So I want to use those. I think they'll fit good on that back fender. So I want to use those for sure. So always save your cool decal sheets. This kit's out from AMT, and so was the Wildcat. That's why I'm showing you the decal sheet for it. Colored in the door panels on the car. Just made a nice little line down each one. Didn't do the door handles. Just the panels where you can see where the doors were welded together. I used my Molotow black liner for those. Available at Model Roundup. So we got our exhaust pipes, we got our nice air cleaner that will end up getting glued on there. I just don't want to knock it off when I'm putting the body together. And then we've got our cool hood scoop. That's how she's going to look all put together before the decals. I'm just loving it. That is going to be a tough looking race car. That's just pretty much going to fall over the top like so. It's going to get pushed down, of course, much farther. So let me get those together. Let me get my decals on from my two big sheets from AMT kits recently, and we will be back for that final. Okay, quick little interjection here. I've slipped the body over in it and it drops over easily, but do you notice a slight issue? It's sitting a half an inch over the top of those rear wheels, and it won't go down any farther because it is on that rear tarp and that rear roll cage where they have me assemble it. So gonna have to make some adjustments, I think, and everything's really loose, so stuff might fall off here. But I'm going to take the body off, and you can see how easy it drops over. What I'm going to have to do is go back and take that right off before it falls off. I'm going to have to cut these right there and tilt this down at an angle to reach that rear frame. And that should be very easy to do. Just take my cutters, hack it off flush, and then push it down and glue it to the corners there. And that should eliminate the problem. If it doesn't, I'll let you know, but I think that'll get rid of it. So if it does, we'll be back for the final as soon as I make that fix. All done and ready to hit the small town racetracks. AMT's 1965 Chevelle modified stocker, a cool kit. I've seen some of these similar. I built like the Vega one, and what was that other one that I built a while ago, the Pinto, that were kind of race cars like this. This one's just a much larger in size and has some cool features, different features. So everything on there is awesome. Just to remind you, in that box, these are the decals that will be in it that I used numerous ones from. And then I added the Ed's Paint Shop decals from the 66 AMT Wildcat review. Now, of course, you do have to fix that roll cage in the back if you want the back end to come down. I just snipped those off. There will be pictures of what it looks like in both versions at the end of the video, where it's sitting up where the instructions tell you and where it's slanted down. I actually like the slanted down look now that I fixed it. Don't forget the extra floater tire. That would be a beautiful tire for any truck racing diorama sitting in the back of a truck or in a garage somewhere. So that's an excellent tire to use if you decide not to go with one floater tire and the big slicks. All the decals went down beautifully. No ripping, no tearing. They lined up nicely. The kit fits well. I mean, there's not much to worry about fit because it's not a real car, so there's no dashboard to worry about or interior door panels. It's just a body shell that gently snaps right over the top of the frame. And then you've got that large roll cage and chassis. The 454 fits under the hood easily, and there's no issues with that. So I loved building this one up as a nice, clean track racer, a paved track, because they are the slicks. Also, as we showed you in an upcoming, you know, videos, I do have the 66 Chevy, and it's not the exact same kit, okay? It's not the exact same chassis, wheel, or anything. It's quite a bit is different between the two kits. So I will be building that one and deciding on a theme for it, but this bad boy in front of you could be built this way. You could build it any other way you want. I like that they now include that little piece of Lexan screen for the window. That's a pretty cool idea, and it goes in easy with that Mod Podge. Fits in there without clouding up or screwing up. So thanks for watching the workshop. As I remember, always stay safe, have fun, stay home and build models while you're worried about everything out there, and let it take your mind off of it. Make sure models are fun for you and you don't worry about anything too much and get stressed out when you're enjoying yourself, because this is a hobby and I want you to have fun. We thank Round 2 Models for sending this over for review. This is available right now. I will put links down below where you can order this kit and get it shipped to you along with that 66 Chevy and all the other stuff that I've reviewed so far. Thanks for watching the workshop. Build for you, have fun, and we will see you at the next review.